kind of structured around five pillars or themes, as you'll see, which is ambitious, fair, green, connected, and together. And within it, it has four time slices, each one with 25 days, so that we can continue to drive delivery and track our progress. The plan contains devolution objectives, key projects, manifesto commitments, and those events that showcase the Liverpool City region assets and talents, and the key business as usual activities. On the 100-day plan, it's worth noting that there's already significant delivery underway, and we're making progress on the development of the other areas. But there's obviously still more for us to do, more engagement, ensuring that the city region is seizing the big opportunities and setting out a strategic vision and taking forward a programme of transformation. So, this is the time slice one. Since the election and the general election, there's been considerable and significant activities, and you see on the highlights, for instance, the opening of the Alston North West Technology Centre that I mentioned earlier, the very positive meeting with the Minister Ken Gates and the session with Lord Jim O'Neill, the Combined Authority backing Liverpool bid for the 20, it's got 20122 here, so that's a long way off that, with 2022 Commonwealth Games, and the judges, as people know, were in this building only last week to review what the offer is, and we wish Liverpool to the Deputy Mayor the very best of luck. Housing first, you'll also see the feasibility study was announced just the other day, Kate at the back was there at that. So I'm pleased to report that we have delivered on these and much, much more. Time slice two marks the start of the next period, and you see that the halting curve, which we mentioned again, happened earlier today, is on that. That was investment also from the Combined Authority, and this project will improve connectivity to Cheshire and North Wales. And we all know that transport is an important and, in fact, an integral strand of the economic growth plans and of the devolution deal. A key priority for me during the middle term is that we invest in people, primarily ensuring that people have the right skills. So we'll be launching our skills commission with Councillor Mayor and developing our skills strategy. Another priority is that we need to take forward is the tidal barrage so that we can make best use of our natural assets. But there's a lot of that going on which we will report back on, but the government needs also to help us to take this forward. They said in the devolution agreement, and we need to hold their feet to the fire on this one. So I'm pleased to report that we're on track to deliver these actions by mid-August. Time slice three, the third 25-day period, we'll be taking forward work with businesses, including the launch of the Liverpool City Region's Insight Programme, which will be a series of business briefings, workshops, seminars, roundtables, and an annual conference to help drive the growth of the city region economy. We'll be scoping how best to deliver the City Region Innovation Awards and make this a regular fixture. I attended the Merseyside Innovation Awards just the other night with three fantastic nominees, genuinely impressive, and we need to encourage everybody to use the opportunity to celebrate innovation in our city region. We're also ensuring that we're connected through our integrated transport services that are both affordable and sustainable, including the rollout, as you'll see there, of the next fleet of low emission buses. And building our international standing, and given the context of what, as you've said about Brexit, what we do know, see, is that Brexit means Brexit. We need ambassadors who can promote the city region. So this, together with the 2018 International Festival for Business, and the international will be a key mechanism of generating business connections, increasing business transactions, and improving those exports that you refer to. And the final slice, one of my commitments is to ensure that across the city region, we're listening and engaging, bringing together experts and practitioners to respond to the challenges. So the Fairness and Social Justice Advisory Board will be a way that we ensure our policies and strategies put fairness at the heart of what the Combined Authority is all about. And the middle question question time will be another way of further engagement. The first session will be in St Helens, but subsequent events will take place across the whole city region. And you'll see in September and October, that'll be an exciting time when the city region showcases its world-leading assets. I want the city region to be known as a place for doing business in digital and innovation. And although not sure on the plan, there is a statutory obligation on the Combined Authority to set out its revised budget, and that will include a corporate plan for the Combined Authority. And we will keep people regularly updated on what happens in regard to progress to achieve all of those aims and much, much more. Item 14 is the Combined Authority